The cheapest new Apple display available is $1,600, and that's not that cheap. If you're looking for a cheap monitor, for less than a budget monitor, you can get a high-end Apple monitor, which has a better build quality, display, and stand than most cheap monitors. For $50, I picked up this Apple Cinema Display 20-inch, and you might think, I've never heard of that before. Well, that's because this monitor is older than me, as it was sold brand new by Apple in 2004 for around $1,300, back when the Mac lineup made sense. This monitor is made primarily out of aluminum. I have two. One of them has held up amazingly, but one really hasn't. The build quality is amazing. The sides are made out of the classic white Apple plastic, but it's good quality plastic, and neither of mine have yellowed that much over the years. I did buy these used, so I don't know where they came from, though. The top is rounded off, which looks amazing, and the entire monitor, while heavy, feels quality and solid. The stand is very smooth and easy to adjust, and it feels high quality, although there is no height adjustment, which my HP monitor does not have either. This monitor features USB ports and even FireWire ports for those who use FireWire. These are still usable, and they work great for I/O and the such that you'd need USB for, though it's definitely not USB 3 that didn't come out for a few years after this monitor released, so I wouldn't recommend using it with modern storage devices. It works out of the box too. You just plug the USB in. There's no drivers or anything you need to do to make it work, at least on macOS, and I assume the same on Windows. On the right side, there's touch-sensitive buttons for brightness and power. These buttons don't feel cheap. They're pretty responsive and they have less chances to break overuse, like with a normal monitor. These monitors' buttons are way better than my HP monitor's buttons. I don't have to mess around in any menus to do what I need to do. There are no menus on this monitor, and it's just touch and go. This monitor features a 20-inch 1680x1050 panel, which still looks pretty good today. It was released in June of 2004, and for connectivity, it uses a DVI connector. It still has a TFT LCD, unfortunately, not IPS. It has 100 pixels per inch, and this model was discontinued in February of 2009, over 4 years after its release. It weighs 14.5 pounds, which could be good, since occasionally my HP monitor comes close to falling over due to slight desk movements. The colors on this display are good, but Apple and most other monitor manufacturers, for that matter, definitely have came a long way in color science since 2004. One note on brightness, though. As monitors age, the displays weaken, and the brightness on them starts to degrade, kind of like batteries. This could be a bad problem on some used listings, and I've seen many used monitors from places like Goodwill over the years have very bad quality and specifically brightness. But these Apple monitors don't seem to be too bad with degradation, although both of mine are significantly degraded, and they would probably not be that good for color work. I'm not the best person to ask about this, as I don't exactly know why this happens or how, but all I know is that these are darker now than when they came out. I got a very good deal on one of my cinema displays. For $48.66 total, including tax and shipping, I got the monitor, its power supply, and two adapters, all in its original box. This was a very good deal considering it included the original box. I got a second one at the same time for $52.50, including shipping and tax, but it didn't come with a power supply, so I have to spend another $20 or so on that eventually. Even with that said, you can easily find these for less than $100 on eBay, or exactly $100 before tax. The adapters to make these work with a modern Mac go for around $5 to $10 for a decent option, but overall, the Apple monitors go for around $100 for the monitor, power adapter, and adapters for using it with a modern Mac. And I think that's pretty good considering my HP monitor, I assume, goes for around $150 to $250. It is not the highest end HP monitor, but it's not the lowest end from what I can tell. Of course, I did not pay for this monitor, I got it for free from somebody. And if you look at many new budget monitors, they all have flaws. Look at my monitor that I've been using for a few months as an example. It has this cheap plastic enclosure painted to look like metal in some areas, which makes noises whenever you adjust it, a cheap stand which looks decent but has no adjustability, other than some slight tilt adjustment, and it is very creaky and wobbly whenever adjusting it. And the menu and user interface is just terrible, with no idea what you're doing most of the time. Every other modern monitor that I've used has had these issues, and this horrible UI. And if I had to pay for this HP monitor, I'd be pretty angry with what I got. Can you use these Apple Cinema displays with a modern Mac? Yes. For a 20 or 23 inch cinema display, all you need is a DVI to USB-C or HDMI adapter. You could probably even use VGA. For whatever reason, whenever I try to connect my cinema display to my J5 Create dock, it doesn't work correctly, but plugging it into my HDMI port directly on my MacBook Pro, it works perfectly. This could be due to my Amazon adapter, or it could be due to a port directly on my dock being broken. It also could be some other issue. If you buy a 30-inch cinema display, though, it can be a mess. There are multiple videos explaining how to use a 30-inch cinema display with a modern Mac, but I don't have one, so I wouldn't be able to properly explain how to do so. I think that I've spent my money wisely on these monitors, since they're great for what I'm using them for, and they still seem to have a bit of life left in them. Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, I'd appreciate a like, and if you want to see more content like this, you can subscribe. Goodbye. One last note is that I have been using this monitor standalone a bit. I haven't used my HP monitor to edit pretty much the last 3/4 of this video, as it's connected to my Xbox right now. So whatever you see in the last 3/4 is color corrected and edit on this cinema display.